the lovely lady that I adore more than anyone is here. Lana Del Rey! How are you?
Yeah, I'm better now.
I'm so happy to see you today.
I'm so happy to see you.
I bumped into you as I walked out of the very unglamorous toilets at Radio 1.
And what a good surprise it was.
Are you well, my darling?
Yeah, I'm good. I feel tired right now, but I'm happy to be here.
You just flew in this morning, right?
Yeah, yeah.
From?
I just saw a show and visited some friends for one day in Italy.
Wow.
So,
but back in sort of your second home now.
Yeah, definitely.
You've been here a lot.
I've been here a lot. I've been here a long time.
Do you like it here now? Are you kind of feeling quite at home?
Yeah, I feel better here now.
Do you?
Yeah.
What do you like about being in the UK the most, would you say?
I like that people have a good taste and they show it, you know, like I feel like I personally just feel supported. And then, I mean, musically. And then other than that, I guess the best thing is that people are so funny just right off the bat. So funny right away. I mean, everyone, just if you walk into a bar or you walk into work, you know, just very clever.
And as you said, I guess musically it did kick off for you here. I've been playing you for over a year now, and it's kind of, we have supported you right from the start.
Yeah, I mean, that's like an understatement. There are really no words. I mean, it started here, it's still here, and the love is really still here. Like, you know, the questions people ask me from the UK and in Europe are so good in interviews, and the things they write are smart. And, you know, America is a different story. And you have been an angel, which I've said a million times.
Oh.
And you know what I appreciate the most is that you're the kind of person who supports other people who you think are good people. And it's so rare that you have advocates like that these days, and it's missing from music and from everything else. And so I love you for that reason and for lots of other reasons, and I'm just really grateful.
Well, I'm so grateful that you wrote Video Games, because it's still one of those songs that just, it just gets me. When I was sort of sat looking online and checking things out about you this morning, I was listening to Video Games again, and it's just the most beautiful song. I absolutely adore it. So I had to play. As soon as I heard it, I spoke to Phil. This was over a year ago.
Yeah.
I was like, I've seen this video. There's this girl. She's amazing. I love the song. And then, you know, luckily, we just got to play it. And it's
I remember
good.
That. I was in California. I was writing the rest of the record. And someone said that, my manager and lawyer said that you were playing it back in London. And after you did that, everything changed a lot. I got my first record deal right after, my second record deal right after that. I mean, it hasn't all been easy, but the best thing is that I got to make my beautiful videos, and I finished the record, and sonically it's really beautiful. So it's funny how you can really trace life changes like that back to a few people, and you're one of those people, and it's really interesting. And yeah,
well, I'm just so really happy cool. for you, because I absolutely love what you do. And
thanks.
You know, it has happened quickly for you. You know, in just over 12 months, you've kind of gone from playing small venues to playing huge festivals like our Hackney weekend that's coming up. How do you feel about that? That's a big shift in audience.
Yeah. I mean, I guess I'm just you just really, if you're me, you just don't really know what to expect. Like, I played Sonar for thousands of people in Barcelona. It was like a dubstep festival. And I, you know, was playing right in the middle of it at midnight and with no drummer. It's a jazz and blues set. And I thought I was going to be totally screwed. But, you know, people were so receptive to me and knew all the words. And so it made me realize, like, you don't have to, it doesn't have to be like everything else out there. You just have to mean it. So the audience has changed, but they're people who seem like they really like the music, which is shocking always. So I'm happy.
I mean, at the weekend, as you say, there's lots of different genres of music out there. And on,
yeah.
You're on Sunday, you're on after Enter Shikari, who could not be more polar opposite to you. And then you're on before Magnetic Man, who were on before Chase and Status. Have you seen those guys before?
No.
Oh my God, they're so loud.
Oh, really?
Chase and Status are so loud, the floor shakes when they play.
Really?
Yeah. Anyone else that you're really excited to see on that lineup? Because you've got like Jay-Z and Rihanna, so many other amazing guys who play over here a lot. Any of them that you know that you want to see?
I don't know. I don't know them, but I'm excited to see them. And isn't Professor Green playing?
Professor Green's going to be there as well.
Gotta see him.
Gotta see him. Yeah,
definitely.
Plan B as well.
Interesting.
Definitely. The lineup is so, so strong. It really is. So let's talk about what's happened to you over the last year, because it has been insane. Over the last 12 months, you've won yourself a Brit Award, an Ivan Novello. You've had a number one album. Have you had a chance to sort of digest all of that?
I don't know. It sounds better coming out of your mouth than the way it feels.
Is it scary? Scary thing to experience that all in 12 months?
No. You know what's scary is, like, when you focus on being a writer for 10 years, and then after that, people start listening to the work and they decide that they don't like you. And that's kind of off-putting. Mm. Just because when you've put all your work into, like, crafting words and melodies, and then people start thinking about you as a person, you know, that's a little off-putting. I don't know, but the rest of it isn't scary. It's just different, and my hobbies are still sort of the same. I've been, you know, interested in the same things for a long time. I was just kind of doing research of my own on other things I was interested in for the last, like, 8 years. So I still, you know, I've just been writing a little bit and taking things slowly when everything's going kind of quickly. So
does it feel a bit like there's a huge whirlwind going on around you quite a lot of the time?
It just feels like a lot of the time, a lot of the options that are available are really not right for me, like, in terms of things that come up. And I just wonder if that's because I'm really difficult, or if, you know, I don't like to be ungrateful, but sometimes things come up and I just think, yeah, man, I don't want to do that. But
I guess less is more sometimes as well. You want to do things that you're passionate about, and that stands for something.
Yeah, I think that's what I was trying to get at. Like, it's still so important to follow your gut and your intuition, and sometimes it's harder to do that when there's a lot of things that you could do.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
I keep being totally distracted by your amazing nails. Oh my, have you seen this, producer Phil? You've got the most incredible, are they real? Nice, yeah. They're insane.
Thank you.
You've got these amazing long silver talons. We need to take a photo of those. Okay. They're absolutely beautiful.
They're chrome, yeah.
I love those.
Thank you.
Lana, you've totally outshone my rubbish sort of lime green ones.
That's the only thing I've outshone you in.
Love those. Right, I tell you what, we're going to play your session from when you were on Zane's show a little while ago, because I want to play video games so bad. I still love this song, and I will go all shivery and probably have a tear in my eye.
Okay.
Stay with us, Lana Del Rey, and we'll put some listener questions to you after this.
This is
Fearne Cotton
on BBC Radio 1.
That was live to a Zane Lowe session a little while ago now. Lana, I just love that song more than anything.
Yeah, thank you, Fearne.
It's just last summer to me. That song just sort of basically is last summer. So beautiful. Lana, I've got lots of questions coming in from listeners. So, first of all, Hannah says, will you be releasing Dark Paradise as a single?
Dark Paradise as a single? No, but I will have a video for it, but not until September.
And you've just done the video for National Anthem.
I have, yeah. Yeah, I was just saying, I have to say, every so often I top what I've done, and this video is definitely the most beautiful thing I've ever done. I wrote a treatment for me and ASAP Rocky, because I just thought he'd be really perfect to star in it, and it's just like, it's a 10-minute video, and Anthony Mandler directed it, and I love it.
Oh, I can't wait to see it. We'll see that soon. We'll let you know when it's up as well. How exciting. Olivia says, will you be touring the UK soon?
Yeah, sort of. I mean, I'm doing, you know, we're doing so many festivals. Well, they're more European this summer. So I won't tour like in a normal way until October again.
Okay, that's exciting. We'll put that in the diary.
Okay.
And Jasmine says, what has been your most embarrassing moment on stage?
Every moment's pretty embarrassing.
Why?
It's the moments in between that are sometimes good, my dear. And the rest of it is pretty messy.
Have you done it like a big trip over or have anything done like that?
No. I mean, you know, for some reason, whenever I start each set, I feel really nervous. So I'm completely breathless from my first song and a half. So that's always interesting to get through. And yeah, it depends.
This is a really sweet question from Darren. Do you enjoy reading? If so, what are your favorite books?
I do enjoy reading. I was actually thinking about that on my way over here. I read the same things over and over again. I really like certain passages out of Whitman's Leaves of Grass, and also Allen Ginsberg, who has a shorter poem called Howl. And both of those writers are kind of like my first and last inspirations. They were kind of the first people I saw make their words really electric and come alive off the page, really visual writers. So, yeah.
That's interesting. Is it kind of intrinsically linked to your music, would you say, kind of reading and stuff for you? Yeah.
Well,
or poetry?
Not just reading, but I would say definitely the greats, like Nabokov and Whitman and Ginsberg, and just those. Yeah.
Okay. People tweeting as well, like Liv says, at Lana Del Rey, is there a song you never get tired of, your favourite song ever? Such a tough question, isn't it? It's like, how do you even start with that one?
I like listening to Janis Joplin's live version of Summertime. Time of the Season. What's your name? Who's your daddy? Boom, boom. Is he rich like me? Yeah.
Such a good song,
so
isn't
good,
it?
Yeah.
I love that
and
tune.
And Hotel California. Eagles.
Amazing. Yeah. Now, Lana, I know that you've told me not to mention the B word.
Oh, Fern.
I'm not going to mention it. But I did make you some cakes. Now, I've had a disaster. I've really had a disaster.
What happened?
What happened is, I love baking. I'm a very keen baker. I don't know if you know this about me, but I bake all the time. So I made really cute little cupcakes. Now, I was stuck in awful traffic, and I did quite a harsh break in my car. Got them out the boot, and they're all upside down.
Can I
see them? They're kind of crushed, and the icing's all mushed up, but it's the thought that counts. So there you go.
Thank you.
I'm embarrassed giving them over to you, quite frankly.
Hold on,
they're that bad.
Let's see.
They're all crushed.
Oh, they're not. They're perfect.
No, they're not. They're not.
What are you talking about?
Don't you laugh.
They look like little pink slippers. They have pearls on top of these pink cakes that look
so
like
pretty.
Roses.
They were so pretty last night. It's such a shame.
You're a better woman than me. I can only make, like, spaghetti.
Oh, well, I love baking, and I put a lot of love into those, and it all went wrong on my awful journey to work. So there we go. We'll put a picture of my rubbish cakes online. Lana, it's been a total pleasure having you in the studio.
Thank you, friend.
So good to see you, as always. Nice, and you're going to be in Hackney, so I'll see you then.
Yeah.
Performing on Sunday, live at the Hackney Weekend. I'm going to play you a song now. I think you might quite like this. There are three girls I'm completely obsessed with at the moment.
Really?
Called Higham. And they're sisters. And I just think this song is absolutely brilliant. It's cute and it's kooky, and the video's really great as well. And it's definitely my song of the summer so far. And it's
really?
My big thing. Yeah, I'm playing it every day this week. So see what you think. And Lana Del Rey, thank you very much for coming in today.
Thank you.
Remember me, remember love, remember China.